charges with those bastards breathing down our necks.
Clear out the darkspawn.
On their heels. Keep it up! The seal's clear! Prime the charges!
Now, set the charges!
Inquisitor, meet Lieutenant Wren, a veteran of the 5th Flight and one of the Legion's finest commanders.
Someone paid her to say that.
Appreciate the help, Inquisitor. Collapsing that seal bought us time. Blighters had the run of these tunnels for days. Now they have a roadblock.
How many deep roads are there? How deep do they go?
They'll take you from one side of Thedas to the other, if you have a death wish.
The roads once connected dwarven cities that were hundreds of miles apart. Then came the Darkspawn. Wren and I have been exploring this region, reclaiming it, but the work is slow.
Mark the map, fight an army, mark the map, fall in a hole, and so on.
I get the impression you two have known each other a while.
Yeah. The Shaper had sent her to dig up some relics. Asked me to keep her out of trouble. That was 3 years ago.
You can quit any time.
Not when we still have things to fight about.
The Legion of the Dead has the Inquisition's full support.
That's the best news I've heard since the quakes began. Actually, the only good news.
Thank you.
heard that, yes. The rhythm in the tremors? It's clearer, stronger, more insistent.
I hear it. Doesn't prove a thing.
These quakes are not a natural disaster. They're deliberate. There's an intelligence behind them.
If something is causing them, the strength required would be incredible. What could do that?
Here we go.
I found an ancient text during an expedition with Ren last year. At the time, it was just a curiosity. But now? The text describes giant creatures, called titans, living deep underground. They sing in the stone, shaping it. When these quakes began, I believe we heard that rhythm. I believe a titan is causing all this destruction.
Mysterious songs often lure people to their deaths, or to an archdemon.
This rhythm isn't a song, exactly. It sounds like air flowing through lungs.
Air that can collapse a whole mine.
A mystery worth investigating.
I've never heard of titans before. What else can you tell me about them?
The text I found predated the First Blight. Its pages had mostly rotted away. And there's no mention of the titans in Orzammar's memories.
Which tells you something.
All I heard was an earthquake. How is it you and Ren hear a rhythm?
Our people have a strong connection to the stone. We feel it in a way topsiders cannot.
Shapers have great stone sense, and Volta's better than most. She never gets lost.
You speak of the stone like it's more than walls.
The stone is eternal. She was here before us, and remains after we die.
But the stone isn't your god.
We don't worship her, but we do respect and honor her.
The stone makes us strong, and we return that strength to her when we die. It's difficult to express in words.
In my experience, no explanation is too strange to consider.
For all we know, that text you found was a bedtime story. We can't be sure until we find the source.
The rhythm I sense in the quakes is emanating from somewhere far below. The stone will lead us there.
And if it comes to a fight, that'll be our job. There's a lift at the side passage nearby. Ready when you are.
everyone's lips. Even the Assembly has taken an interest. I'm told King Balin wished to meet you personally, but the Deshos talked him down. The earthquakes present too great a risk. When the previous king died, Orzammar nearly fell apart.
How does one become a Shaper of Memories?
I was born with a keen stone sense. It caught the Shaper's attention, but my passion for history earned me the title. It was never really a choice.
You seem quite excited by the idea that these titans may exist.
My connection to the stone allows me to hear it, but I can only listen. Titans can sing through the stone. It is extraordinary. We call ourselves children of the stone. What does that make the titans?
What's life like in Orzammar?
I haven't lived in Orzammar for 3 years, but I receive updates. Is there anything in particular you'd like to know?
Do you miss living there?
I do sometimes. Particularly the easy access to a warm bath and clean clothes. But the importance of my work outweighs the comforts of the city.
The dwarves' caste seems to dictate their entire life in Orzammar.
I could bore you for hours about our society's castes and the tensions that go along with them. Simply put, citizens of Orzammar are born into a caste, and that is their lot in life. A member of the Smith caste can never join the Warrior caste, and vice versa. Everything is predetermined.
There's no way for someone to change castes.
It is possible for a member of the lower caste to marry above their station. But only their children's caste will improve. Similarly, when dwarves are made casteless, so are their descendants.
How's the political climate in Orzammar?
There have been riots due to food shortages, but they will pass, I hope. I've no doubt some Deshers will try to use the situation for their own gain. But the king has a good hold over the Assembly.
What are Deshers?
Members of the Assembly. All noble-born. Through the Assembly, they govern Orzammar. The king presides over them.
Caste seems to dictate their entire life in Orzammar.
I could bore you for hours about our society's castes and the tensions that go along with them. Simply put, citizens of Orzammar are born into a caste, and that is their lot in life. A member of the Smith caste can never join the Warrior caste, and vice versa. Everything is predetermined.
No way for someone to change castes.
It is possible for a member of the lower caste to marry above their station, but only their children's caste will improve. Similarly, when dwarves are made casteless, so are their descendants.
That's enough about Orzammar.
Of course.
Thanks for the insight, Shaper.
My pleasure, Inquisitor.
We'll speak another time.
So it's true. The king involved a servicer.
I hope we don't run into an emissary.
Oh. Now we definitely will.
I take it emissaries are bad.
Most Darkspawn are mindless killing machines, connected by the Blight. But emissaries are intelligent. And use magic.
Darkspawn.
Well, everyone's got their favorites.
This belonged to an exiled dwarf. He was experimenting with raw lyrium.
This door, there's something strange about it. Looks like our construction, but...
It's missing gears.
We have to find them. It's our only way through. should only need one more. We have enough of these odd gears. Let's head back to the door.
Thank you.
Only a Lyrium-addled mind would hide secrets behind such madness.
Ren, I'm sorry about Bernat. You served with him a long time.
It was quick. And Bernat returned to the stone with honor. We should all be so lucky.
It's all right to be upset.
I'm too old to be upset.
It's open. Keep any gears we find. We may need more. And if we don't, I want to study them. Whatever they're made of wasn't mine down here. Another strange door. Who put these here? And why?
This one uses a different kind of gear from the others.
We don't have to open it. My stone sense leads the other way. Though I am curious to see the other side.
You always are.
scar on your nose is new.
Yeah. Fell out of bed.
You sleep on the ground.
Surprised me too.
This Grey Warden had a map. Could be important.
Thank you.
kill Darkspawn like you've been doing it your whole life, Inquisitor.
He means that as a compliment.
You're famous, even down here. Is it true you killed a dragon?
Magnificent creatures. Bringing one down is always bittersweet.
I can't even imagine. Tell me about their teeth. I've heard they don't all breathe fire, and their scales have different colors and patterns.
Careful, Ren. I believe you're drooling.
Thank you.
Tighedron?
Darkspawn all over it. You can see their torches.
We're getting close to something.
Aye. The fight of our lives.